let's check searching with wildcard characters. You can get the most out of your searches with the power of wildcards. Wildcards allow you to match variations and patterns in your search terms, expanding your results beyond exact matches. You can use wildcard characters in your global text search, knowledge bases, searchable lists, and reference fields. In this table, you can see all wildcards with some examples for each. There are two types of wildcards, single character and multiple character wildcards. With single character wildcard, you can use the percent sign to match any single character in a specific position. For example, you can search for TE%T to find words like text or test. For multiple character wildcard, you can use the asterisk to match any sequence of characters, including zero character, in a specific position. For example, you can search for PL*D to find words like planned or placed. You can use wildcards anywhere in your search term. You can combine multiple wildcards in a single word. For example, you can search for %FF%R* to find words like affordable, effort, or offering. Here is an example of a global search with a mix of wildcards. If your wildcard search returns too many results, you can try narrowing it down with more specific terms. There are things that administrators can do by adjusting the global limit for wildcard search results. Please note that wildcards work best with words containing multiple letters. Using them within pictogram characters might lead to excessive results. ServiceNow supports several wildcard characters to expand and refine the search results. Here are the available list search wildcards. You can use an asterisk with a search term to search for values that contain that search term. If you start with a percent sign and your search term next, you're basically searching for values that end with that search term. You can start with an equal sign and then your search term, and that searches for values that equal search term, and that is the exact match for that particular search term. You can also use the exclamation mark to provide the opposite results. For example, starting with an exclamation mark and then an asterisk with a search term allows you to search for values that don't contain that search term. Starting with an exclamation mark and then the equal sign with your search term searches for values that don't equal that particular search term. Let's start testing the wildcard characters. Before I start, let me search for a keyword in the short description without a wildcard. Let's try email. It returns all incidents where the short description starts with the keyword email. Now, if I use the asterisk wildcard in the beginning of the keyword email and search for it, I can see the list of all incidents where the short description contains the word email. This includes those incidents that also start with the keyword email. If I change that to percent sign and search it again, I can see the list of all incidents that the short description ends with the keyword email. This time, let's try the exclamation mark with the asterisk and search for the keyword email. This lists all incidents where the short description does not contain email. Now let's try the equal sign wildcard. Let's search for reset my password. I can see there are two incidents where the short description is an exact match to my search term. If I use the exclamation mark in the beginning of my search, this should return all incidents where the short description is not reset my password. Please note that there is a difference between the column search we're doing and the list search that sits on the top of the form on the title bar. I'm going to search on the number column. If I search for all incidents that contain the number 90, I get a few results. However, if I use the percent sign in the beginning and then the number 90, I can only see one match, and that's the incident where the number ends with the number 90. When I'm using the list search, I would see a different behavior. Let's try number from the list and search for the number 90. Interestingly, I get the same result since the list search returns all incidents where the number ends with 90. I can use wildcards in the list search when I'm searching for a text, and that means I'm searching for all keywords in the ticket, not only the short description. For the keyword phone, with a percent sign in the beginning, I can only see one match, and that's the incident where the keyword iPhone is listed in the short description. Now, let me change my wildcard to the asterisk. I'm presented with a list of all incidents where the keyword phone is listed there. So I can see iPhone, my desk phone, headphone, and probably incidents where the keyword phone is somehow being used in the ticket. In this example, I can see the keyword phone in the description of this incident. I probably can see the same result, not necessarily in the short description, but in the other fields of the incident. Now, I want to use multiple wildcards in my search term. Let's try to mix them. This time, I'm going to use the percent sign, the letter M, asterisk, the letter L. Let's see what results we get. In my search results, I can see email, but at the same time, I can see employee. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. See you soon!